Good morning. Welcome to the Church of St. Patrick. Today we celebrate the third Sunday of Easter. Please take a bulletin home with you after Mass. It has our many parish activities listed. Kindly make sure all cell phones are turned off before we begin our liturgy. As we continue to celebrate this glorious season of Easter, our readings today show us how the resurrection was preached and made manifest to the early church. They also indicate how Jesus' first followers were strengthened in their faith, becoming enthusiastic and faithful witness to the risen Lord. We remember at this Mass Olga Lizak. Our presider is Father Rogers. Please stand and join in singing our gathering hymn, Festival Canticle number 834, 834.
Let us take a moment and prepare our hearts to receive Jesus by calling to mind our weaknesses, asking the Lord for his pardon and peace. Lord Jesus, you came to save us from our sins. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your divine mercy is without end. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
So that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the captain and the court officers had brought the apostles in and made them stand before the Sanhedrin, the high priest questioned them. "We gave you strict orders, did we not, to stop teaching in that name? Yet you have filled Jerusalem with your teaching and want to bring this man's blood upon us." But Peter and the apostles said in reply, "We must obey God rather than men. The God of our ancestors raised Jesus, though you had him killed by hanging him on a tree. God exalted him at his right hand as leader and savior, to grant Israel repentance and forgiveness of sins. We are witnesses of these things, as is the Holy Spirit, whom God has given to those who obey him." The Sanhedrin ordered the apostles to stop speaking in the name of Jesus and dismiss them. So they left the presence of the Sanhedrin, rejoicing that they had been found worthy to suffer dishonor for the sake of the name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, looked and heard the voices of many angels who surrounded the throne and the living creatures and the elders. They were countless in number, and they cried out in a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches, wisdom and strength, honor and glory and blessing." Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea, everything in the universe, cry out, "To the one who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be blessing and honor, glory and might forever and ever." The four living creatures answered, "Amen," and the elders fell down and worshiped. The word of the Lord.
Together were Simon Peter, Thomas called Didymus, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, Zebedee's sons, and two others of the disciples. Simon Peter said to him, "I am going fishing." They said to him, "We also will come with you." So they went out and got into the boat. But that night, they caught nothing. When it was already gone, Jesus was standing on the shore, but the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. Jesus said to them, "Children, have you caught anything to eat?" They answered him, "No." So he said to them, "Cast the net over the right side of the boat, and you will find something." Cast it, and were not able to pull it in because of the number of fish. So the disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, "It is the Lord." When Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he tucked in his garments, for he was lightly clad, and jumped into the sea. The other disciples came in the boat, for they were not far from shore, only about 100 yards, dragging the net with the fish. When they climbed out on shore, they saw a charcoal fire with fish on it and bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you just caught." Simon Peter went over and dragged the net ashore full of 153 large fish. Even though they were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come, have breakfast." And none of the disciples dared to ask him, "Who are you?" because they realized it was the Lord. Jesus came over and took the bread and gave it to them, and in the like manner, the fish. This was now the third time Jesus was revealed to his disciples after being raised from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is a very special day in your life. You're going to receive another sacrament. Sacraments are truly important, like your baptism. When you were baptized, your parents declared you're for the Lord, and the Lord is a special person in your life forever. And then you made your first sacrament of reconciliation. Ask the Lord to be with you, purifying you, blessing you, so that you could be ready for this day, your first Holy Communion day, the second sacrament of initiation. You got one more sacrament of initiation. Does anybody know what the next one will be? What's the next sacrament of initiation? Confirmation, of course. Then you will have received all three sacraments of initiation. Today we have some very special readings for your first Holy Communion day. And they're so appropriate. It says that Jesus took bread and he gave it to his disciples. It's like Holy Communion. So Jesus is in his new body, his resurrected body, and he's on the shore. And you can almost picture him. Hello out there. Did you catch any fish? How many fish did they catch? 153. Very good. You were paying attention. 153 fish. That sounds like an odd number, but it's really symbolic. Some people did some research, and they found the Greek zoology book, and it said at that time of Jesus, they knew that there was 153 different species of fish. So it's a symbolic number that Jesus, the fact that there's 153, that means he is for everybody. So it's not really it's a fishing story, but it has a lot of meaning to it. That Jesus came for everybody. And there's another little clue in that gospel that there were some people who were the disciples who were out in the boat. If we count their heads, how many were in the boat? It says there were seven. And it names them. But the seven is also a symbolic number. St. John, the one who wrote it, he liked to use a lot of symbols. And so the number seven means perfection, fulfillment. So it means something really important, that Jesus is the fulfillment. He is the promised one. He is the fulfillment of our desires, of our life. He makes us whole. He fills us with his joy, his love. And he is the perfect one. And we draw so much strength and blessing from Jesus. And then we have something else in this. At the end of this gospel reading, there's another word that really stands out. And the word is, amen, amen, I say to you. That's Jesus talking. Amen, amen, I say to you. Whenever we all know the word amen, right? It's at the end of our prayers. When we say the Our Father, there's an amen at the end. At the end of Mass, there's an amen. So we use amen a lot. And we use it to end a prayer, but we also use it to talk about truth. That's how Jesus used it. Whenever he said amen, I mean, this is important. You got to listen to this. Whenever he said amen, amen, the double amen, he's saying, this is really important. Don't miss this teaching. And so we had the double amen in today's gospel. Amen, amen, I say to you. So Jesus is saying and talking to Peter on how he will serve the Lord. And at the very end, after he told Peter something really, really important, I need you. I need you to be number one among the apostles. You are rock, and upon you I will build my church. I need you to turn away your doubt and make your affirmation. And Peter says, Lord, you know I love you. Three times. Just like he disowned him 3 times, now Peter returns that, and he admires Jesus 3 times. He affirms Jesus as Lord. And Jesus' response? Then get to work. He's telling St. Peter, he says, that I need you. Go out, feed my sheep, tend to my sheep, feed my lambs. He uses that the first one, feed my lambs. So feed the children, feed the small ones. And then don't forget to feed the adults and the grandparents too. Feed the sheep, tend to the sheep. Jesus is telling Peter to get to work, not to be a farmer, but to be a disciple. And he's speaking to you today on your first communion day. And he's asking you to be one of his friends, one of his disciples. And he's telling us to get to work. Get to work to live our life and serve the Lord with acts of charity and kindness and forgiveness and mercy. Do what would Jesus do? Boys and girls, today, as you get ready for your first Holy Communion, the most important word that you're going to say all day is Amen. I'm going to say the body of Christ, and you're going to say Amen. The word Amen means I believe. This is true. And we're saying yes. This is really the body and blood of Jesus. We believe he is present in the Eucharist. We believe he's present in the tabernacle. Under the form of bread, Jesus is there in your life, in your heart. And so don't forget to thank him today for giving you the gift of Jesus in Holy Communion. And may we also think, how can I serve God? How can I be an instrument of God's peace in my world, in my school, in my family, in the playground? How can I be one of Jesus' friends? How can I imitate him and serve him? As Jesus asked the apostles, he asks you now, the first reading class, be my apostles, be my saints, be my friends who serve me. And to that we say,
Amen.
Please stand. Together we proclaim our profession of faith with the words that were used in our baptism. Now we proclaim our creed, our belief in Jesus, the Holy Spirit, and God our Father. Together, I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for our sin, for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world. Boys and girls, we have just proclaimed our faith, our profession of faith. And now I will bless you with the Easter holy water. I just invite you to make the sign of the cross when I bless you with this Easter holy water. Now let us lift up to the Lord our special prayers for this day.
That we, as the body of Christ, will be strengthened by the Spirit in living out the truth of the resurrection. Lord, in your mercy. That the Lord will grant government leaders throughout the world hearts for justice and peace. Lord, in your mercy. That through the intercession of Immaculate Mary, protector of the Ukraine, reconciliation will overcome hatred, peace will conquer war, hope will replace despair, and God's plan for the world and for all its people will be fulfilled. Lord, in your mercy. That during the Easter season, all priests, especially Father Phil, our pastor, and Father Barnabas, our associate, will enjoy the faithful support, gratitude, and encouragement of the people they serve. Lord, in your mercy. That all in our Christian community will always welcome the unborn, the stranger, and all who are vulnerable. Lord, in your mercy. That God will grant the sick and those who care for them and those who have asked us to pray for them healing, relief, and peace. Lord, in your mercy. That all who have died in Christ and those who have died unremembered and unmourned and James Kern Jr. will witness the glory of the risen Lord in the heavenly kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. That Olga Lizak, whom we remember in this Mass, will always share in the eternal banquet. Lord, in your mercy. And for all those petitions we hold deep in our hearts, Lord, in your mercy.
Let us pray for children around the world receiving their first Holy Communion, especially the children in Ukraine. We pray to the Lord. God, as we present you these prayers and petitions, may we also declare to you our love. Keep us, we pray, always faithful to you throughout our life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please join in singing our preparation hymn, number 708, Lord, When You Came to the Seashore, number 708.
Lord, when you came to the sea.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And we lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself to us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land and every people exult in your praise. Even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Heavenly Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. Grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion, together with Francis our Pope, Alfred our Bishop, with all other bishops, with priests and deacons, and with your entire people. Grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the Gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation, and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. And also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles, the martyrs, Saint Patrick, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer that peace now to those around us.
Thank you.
invite the children who have received their first Holy Communion to please come in the middle aisle, starting with the girls first, in single file. Two girls, and then the boys come out and stand behind them in single file. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord.
Thank you.
and girls, remember what we talked about yesterday, that this is the time of thanksgiving after communion. So I invite you to close your eyes and thank Jesus for the important people in your life, your parents, your grandparents, your teachers, your friends. Just thank God for all the blessings he has given to you. Please stand. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. A couple brief announcements for our parish family. St. Patrick's takeout spaghetti dinner is this Sunday, and they started serving at 11 a.m., and they will serve till 2 p.m. This will be our last spaghetti dinner until the fall. Some people have asked for a Mass on a Saturday morning in the tradition of Our Lady of Fatima, so we will begin that this week for the month of May. It will just be the first Saturday of each month, 8 o'clock in the morning, Saturday morning Mass. Our parish May procession is next week at this Mass at 10 o'clock, so we invite all the children in the parish. Children, you're invited to come back dressed in your First Communion outfits and to be a part of our May procession in which we crown the Blessed Mother. And just come and sit with your families, and then we'll form the procession at the end of Mass. May and June lottery calendars are being sold in the back of the church. They're still only $5. Now, this is really important. As we get, May is the month for Memorial Day, the time we visit our cemeteries. And last year, at Veterans Day, is when we take off the tattered flags, and the people who are helping us were a little over energetic. And they took away the holders for the flag as well, the bronze holder. The good news is we have all of them, but we're not sure where they go. So if you have a relative, some family member, and there was a marker, the bronze marker, the flag holder on their grave last year at this time, please call us and let us know. And we have a whole bit of them, and we'll make sure that one is there for Memorial Day. Any questions about that, just call us at the rectory. Please help us resolve this problem by contacting us if yours is missing. So please check the grave. If it's missing, let us know. At this time, I invite everyone, please be seated for a moment. I'd like to give our children a gift. I invite the boys and girls to come up like you did for communion. The church would like to give you a gift to help you remember this day. Boys and girls, there's some religious items in there, and I will bless them right now. So just hold them in front of you.
God, our Heavenly Father, we ask you to bless the religious items that are in these bags. May they inspire and deepen the faith of all who pray with them. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Boys and girls, I just invite you for one moment to turn around and look at the back of the door. And now let us congratulate you. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. As Mass is ended, let us walk in the light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Recessional hymn number 914, Hail Holy Queen enthroned above, 914.